about adding just-in-time compilation to every level of Postgres. We are doing it at Institute for System Programming at Russian Academy of Sciences. It's me and a few other people. We are doing this for 1.5 years by now, and before that we were doing much of compiler stuff like GCC, LLVM, and JavaScript engines like V8 and WebKit. So we kind of try to apply our experience with compilers, JIT compilers, optimizations to Postgres. And let me tell about what we came up with. So we will be talking about expression JIT. This is about compiling expressions in workflows. Then we will go to full executor JIT, which compiles executor tree nodes. Then, because the compilation takes some overhead, we will try to add some caching to this JITing code. And finally, we do some JIT stuff for creating indexes. Also, we have a few experimental features. So let's move to motivation. First of all, it was very slow, even for simplest examples like this one. In interpreter, before under dispatch, of course, it was 56% of execution just for this simple expression. We replaced this with LVM generated code, and it became just 6% of execution time. So this simple query sped up by 2 times. It was pretty impressive, but it was just a motivation to start.
How large was that
table? I think about 2 gigabytes, like that. So our goals was mostly for analytics, because so to make compile time negligible and make it CPU intensive. The benchmark for it is TPCH. That was our aim for optimizing. And we are doing this with dynamic compilation just in time. And every time I talk about this, it may be third conference, people ask me, okay, so what's the difference? Why wouldn't we just compile it with LLVM, with -L3, and get all the optimizations? So in case you wanted to ask, the more information we have, the better code we get. At the time of query execution, we know much more information than we would at the building Postgres database server. So there are a lot of info like database scheme, the tables are affected, the attributes used, the layout for those attributes in table, execution plan, the condition in workflows, all that put together, it's like you are writing, you can write a specialized C code to run this query and optimize it specifically for your SQL query. So we can do much better than in general case. There is a lot of related work. The classics is Newman's paper, which was done for Hyper, if I'm not mistaken, a database. Then VitesseDB, a proprietary database, followed this path. And we were inspired by Vitesse, actually. And they achieve pretty impressive speedups, and even more with column storage and such things. But the base for their performance is just-in-time compilation of full executor tree and switching to push model. In Tallinn, Dennis Butterstein presented his work, which is very, very similar to ours. And of course, Andres, who started working on executor, improving executor, and then switched to JIT. So this is basically what we do. The dragon is for LLVM, the elephant for Postgres. For expression stuff, this is before Andres patch, so we are considering an expression tree. Instead of visiting each node to interpret that and execute, we generate an internal representation for LLVM. So we traverse the tree ordinary way, but instead of executing, we generate LLVM IR. Then we run LLVM to optimize that IR and produce native code. It's pretty compact, simple, and efficient. Another thing we do is supporting backend functions. Backend functions involve such simple things like adding two numbers for different data formats. So if we don't compile those backend functions into LLVM, we have to deal with overhead on even for simple arithmetic operations. We compile those source code from backend directory into LLVM IR, then link it, optimize it, load it to memory buffer, and then link it at compile time with our expression. It's quite similar to what Andres told at the end conference. Yeah. So this is just the first level of JITIN in Postgres we did. And altogether, it gave 20% on TPCH Q1, but it doesn't involve actually slot deformed tuple stuff. So it's not its full potential. And here it says SQRT and POW, but actually plus also requires built-in function. This stuff is available in our GitHub repository, so you can play around. But this only covers, if you look for TPC HQ1, this 6% of total runtime if we use it in very close. If we do it for aggregation, it's of course more, but out of those 75%, the expression stuff is not that much. So to get a big improvement on TPCH, we need to do a full executor just-in-time compilation. Here's what we do. First, we check whether all the tree executor nodes are supported by our JIT. Then we generate the code for the specific query and link with backend functions the way I described it before. To do that effectively, we had to change execution model from pull to push. I will tell more about benefits of switching on the next slides, but here is how it works. In Postgres, it used a Volcano model. It's very old, something from 1994 paper, but it's very kind of intuitive for the programmer. So when you need to print data, you first should request it from sort. The sort, to know what to actually sort, will request it from aggregation layer, and aggregation will kind of sip in tuples through the straw from the 6-con level. And the tuple by tuple, it goes up. The thing is, all the calls, the next calls that gets the next tuple are virtual and thus indirect. The more natural way for the compiler and for a data flow is to turn it upside down. So we scan the table, then aggregate the results, then sort them, then print. It makes sense because the compiler optimizations, because there is no internal state in the iteration. If a 6-con is the bottommost node, you should save the last position. It's to stop the last time it was scanning. Then return next tuple. Then upon calling next from 6-con, it should, oh, let me remember, where did I stop the last time? And all this results in loading and storing the state within the node. So it's an iterator which stores its state, and we need more load stores to get the same semantics. For push model, we can get rid of that, and moreover, because we have a just-in-time compilation, we exactly know what method, for example, what sort or aggregation method we are dealing with. So we don't need virtual or indirect calls. We can generate straight calls, and furthermore, we can inline them because we are JIT compiler. So how it's done? We are starting from the bottommost node, bottom after we turned it, and generating, and first call the generators for sort. They produce the code, LLVM IR code on the left. Then we move to upper nodes. And pass them the functions we just generated. And then continuing to 6-con. So at the right, there are generator functions. At the left, the LLVM intermediate representation code we get. And then we are doing inlining. So all those functions are nicely compacted without any calls at all and without need to store the internal state like it's in pool model in Postgres. Then we can further optimize it with all the optimizations LLVM has and get a compact and very nice code. So this is the next level of JITing we did. We compile execution plan into LLVM API, but we can go further. So there is a sloped deformed tuple function. And when we, yeah.
I've got a question about the previous section you were talking about, turning the executor upside down.
Yeah.
If it's a join or something like that, then you have two sequential scans. Did you make it work for that case as well? And if so, which one did you run first?
Like this?
Yeah, something like that. If you can talk about that later.
Yeah, but in that context, I will talk about doing it without JIT. Okay, first we go to the rightmost leaf, right? And generate all the stuff we need to fill the hash table. Then we do in 6-con for another table and looking up for the value in hash table and push it further to sort. So.
Yeah, so I think with hash join that works, but like with merge join, you need to read some from the left, or some from the inner, some from the outer.
Yeah, in that case, it's hard to implement in pure static C, but when you have generators for code, you can actually generate. Okay, it's not a push model like I can inline them together in this case. But I can generate correct code with LVMIR and actually get the tuple from left and right, because I don't think there is another way for the merge joins. So it works for the good cases, and for the cases it doesn't work good, it generates correct code at least. And no, merge join is not implemented, just a nest loop that's implemented. That is, I guess, similar to what you said. So we also compile attribute accesses. So if we can determine the fixed offset into the tuple to get the attribute, we do that. There are several things we can optimize out, like attribute lengths, nullability, if the table schema allows us that. And the code that you can see at the right can be converted to direct accesses that you can see on the left. Not always, but sometimes it really simplifies. So we are adding another level of cheat to our picture. And altogether, it gives 5.5x speed up for TPCHQ1. Of course, this push switching to push model and generating code can be, it's better to be implemented as an extension, because it's really much code. So it's actually an extension and not a patch to Postgres like the first part for expressions. Here is more detailed results. We implemented most of the executor methods except for those specified in red. This is, yeah.
When you say turned off, did you also turn it off in the Postgres case, in the plain case or not?
Yes. To make it fair. To make it fair.
Well, fair.
And it's a huge database to make compilation time negligible. But actually, it's not. But for queries that run in hours, it may be good. Yeah, also, we have to change some types because they don't play nicely with native CPU types. The next thing we did is JIT compiling index creation. It's the hostest function compare top index B3, which we compiled with comparators for different types, as we discussed with Theodor Sigaev. Yeah. The results are like from 5 to 20% for different data types. So here is another bar for our JITIN picture. Let's get back to 5x speedup. For small queries like OLTP, the compilation time may be a real issue because it's 1.5 seconds. It can be optimized, can be done more effectively, like not compiling all the built-in functions because the bit code for the backend is huge and the linking takes time. We can also compile, use some estimations, how many row numbers there will be. So to process only heavy queries. But there is another solution. This was saving optimized native code for prepared statements. So when the generic plan is saved, we save as well the native code for that. But it takes extra memory, and the native code we can generate for reusing, it's a bit slower and a bit bigger than the native code we generate for the specific query, because it's like if you compile and share in library, you have to specify -fpic, which make it positional independent. And we should be doing patchable code where we can replace addresses for the different Postgres structures it uses. So if we just memcpy the native code, we cannot run it because we should link it with the data structures it actually uses. So there is little overhead for that. Here is the numbers for this simple query. The save a generic plan takes almost seven kilobytes, and JIT extension takes 8 kilobytes for native code. By saving the code, we can eliminate compile time, but there is an overhead for saving it, like extra one and a half kilobytes of memory. For TPCH, the memory overhead is more than that. To make the code patchable, we're using a LLVM patch point. So basically, the two approaches we can use to make the code linkable. The first one is to introduce one level of interaction. So we put the data we need on the side and look up this data with loads. But there is another mechanism in LLVM. So it can generate patchable code, and then before running it, you can almost like a linker does, you can update all the locations in the code you need and put the addresses for the data you want to access. Like I said, for more complex queries, our native code takes up to 2 to 5 times more memory. Then if we just save generic plan with prepared, we can address that by saving the native code just for hottest queries, not the all prepared statements, which could be maybe hundred thousands or millions. We also have tested it on PGBench, and the speedup is pretty impressive because we eliminated the compile time. For native code itself, there is a little bit slowdown because of reusability, because we should be patching it. So on average, it's two times speed up compared to vanilla Postgres. We also have tested it on TPCH, but here the most important results are memory and slowdown for patchable code, because the compile time only matters as much as the smaller database you have, the more compile time matters. For TPCH, it's not that important. So patchable code is like 20 to 30% slower than the native code we can generate without being able to patch it. So we keep adding JIT to our picture, and now we are able to process OLTP queries as well, as long as they're declared as prepared. So the first time it runs, it's compiled to native code. These are intermediate results for this presentation, for this picture, before we go into experimental features. So we have an expression JIT, which is open source, and with 20% speed up, an extension which is still working on with the 5x speed up. We can cache the native code for it, and we can just-in-time compile, creating indexes. Now we move to experimental features. So first of all that we previously talked is manually code generation using the LLVM API. So we really rewritten all executor nodes on LLVM API. We did generators for all of them, and it brings some challenges because it's duplicated semantics. Nobody really wants to make changes in two places, in original Postgres and in our code. So it brings up maintainability questions. The answer could be automatic code specialization. So consider this example. You have a C code, you have a data, and you can specialize your C code for this data. In many cases, it allows you to optimize code better, simplify it. So optimizations like constant propagation folding can be run over it. Then you can optimize control flow. Then you can inline the result and optimize it further and end up in very simple code that is specialized for your data. Now imagine that the program is your PostgreSQL source executor, the data is your SQL query, the compiler is your code specializer, just-in-time compiler, and then you have a native code specialized to run your query. This sounds a little bit sci-fi, but That's what we done actually, and now trying to make it work faster. So for Postgres, there are invariant data, or static data like plan state, execution state, and they don't change. Most of them don't change during the query execution. So you can propagate those as constants. So we know what data is invariant for the given query. LLVM has all data propagation passes. And all we actually need is LLVM to make recognize our data as constant. So first we mark the structures that we know that stay invariant during the execution query, and then have optimization pass in LLVM, which adds them to some address map. Then when we run LLVM optimizer, we modified it to look up these address maps and actually substitute the references by these addresses by the constants, the values that are residing by these addresses. So when we compile Postgres, there is the static version of it, and also there is a Postgres executor code precompiled into bit code. At the runtime, we load up that bit code, and using the specific SQL query, we specialize it to make the native code. In this scheme, we don't, this is the same actually, we don't switch to push model because it's original Postgres code. But this approach solves the problem of maintainability, so we can basically get JIT for free using original Postgres code. For example, in this code in red, there are marked all the data that is available at compile time, I mean JIT compile time. So the code at the left is actually original Postgres code, not the one we wrote with LLVM API. And at runtime specialization, it can be converted to that at the right. Another example, in red there are marked loads, stores, and all the data that we can constant propagate or fold. So we can simplify this graph and even remove the iteration because it's iterating over the list, and if we unroll it, the list is very short and it contains just one element, and we know that this is a list of one element, so we can even remove a loop during such specialization. This is how it happens. We have the original control flow graph for execqual and the parameters. We are just traversing it and substituting parameters for their values and generating the new program at the right. We are doing an iteration here because it's a list, and we end up in very simple code generated at the right. So this is still in progress, and the preliminary results are 28% speed up from runtime specialization. This is not 5x like for extension, but it has some room for improvement. The first thing we looked at that hampers the performance is load store of internal state in executor nodes. The thing we are trying to eliminate with switching to push model. So the next thing is trying to switch the whole Postgres executor to push model so we can JIT compile it during runtime specialization. For the plans like this, it's really simple. So we have the nodes that do all they do is reading, then sort, then passing it to the next node. We can just turn it around and do sysscan the main loop, the outer loop, and make it push data into sort. This would solve our problem of loading stored internal state and make things faster. For such operations, it's no problem. For operations like this, it's also doable, but the source code, the semantics becomes a little bit not that obvious than it was with the Volcano model. Here is a hash join automaton from Postgres. When switching to push model, it gets rewritten with another automaton, which has less states and thus is a little bit faster. This is still work in progress, but we have some prototype that was implemented for a GSOC project by our student, and it gives like a 5 to 10% speed up, mostly because of eliminating sysscan overhead. This was implemented for a limited number of nodes. And we ran the queries from TPCH that was supported. So concluding this part, switching to push model noticeably reduced overhead for executor tree nodes, for leaf nodes like sysscan. We have some improvement like 5 to 10% on TPCH. The prototype actually is available in the mailing list. And our dynamic specializer works better with this push model, but it needs additional tuning. We didn't really have much time to try them together. And hopefully this will give additional speed up. So Andres, you may be interested in seeing these patches.
Yeah, I'd like to look at them.
Okay. So to conclude, we have that big picture with JIT everywhere in Postgres, with expression JIT, compiling just expressions in where clause and aggregation, the full JIT, which compiles all the nodes in execution tree. We can cache that to run short queries like OLTP. We can JIT creating indexes. And to avoid the hassle with extension, with supporting it, we're trying to do runtime specialization of original Postgres code. And to make it more efficient, we even switched some nodes to push model. And all of those brought some speed up, but The best speed up comes from just-in-time compiling the executor tree and generating it LLVM API. So we will be happy to test whatever part we presented with your data, with your workload, and collaborate to develop it further. So if you have any questions, comments or feedback, please write, or any questions. Yeah.
You explicitly mentioned that the first part is open source, but you didn't say anything about this latter part.
Yeah. Open source also is the prototype for switching to push model. It was published. The Postgres extension is not there yet, and we actually don't have much resources to work on this code to make it publicly available. And another thing is, who will benefit from making it just open source without us continuing to working on it? Yeah, but we don't have actual customers because we are an academic institution. So we'd like to have a partner in the industry who can benefit from our work and see what customers really need. So we can develop this work to a really production level. I mean, now it's almost production because it doesn't fail. It passes almost all the tests. But we need a partner who will deploy that and see what else do we need to make it production.
So there's, you know, quite a bit of overlap, it seems like, between what you've done and what Andreas has started on or is working on. So have the two of you seen, you know, kind of different results or results that surprise the other one or taking different approaches?
Yeah, the first thing that we do full JIT for executor nodes, and Anders does expression JIT and slot deformed tuple. Yeah, Anders' results he presented were like 80% on Q1. But the technology is very similar, so.
The reason for that is that in 10, for 10, we evaluate each expression in an aggregate separately, but in 10, we evaluate all the transition values in one chunk. That's why you see 0.96 smaller results of the jitting, of the fast expressions of the jitting, if you place in 0.96 than on 9.10, because you do have one more function cost.
Okay.
I would suspect that if you move yours onto 10, you would probably also see bigger benefit, but purely on the expression side of things.
Okay.
That's
good.
That's just an independent change that made it easier to do more jitting.
Nice. But basically, our expression JIT is more or less very similar. Yeah, but if you do it on the full scale of executor, you can get much more speed up. But it requires more changes in Postgres, like switching to push model, and nobody seems to want that in Postgres right now. I mean, this is a big change, and nobody knows how to do that properly, actually.
There's an unconference presentation about doing
this.
Okay, so you were present. You said nobody seemed interested.
Yeah, Anders has prototypes for that. We have prototypes for that, but nobody knows how to actually put it into Postgres, so to keep it productional. It's a big change.
I think I do think that we have an interest in moving into that interaction, but I think it's like at the very, very early stages.
Let's see. transactional concerns are specifically with the JIT piece or with the...
Well,
you just said like a human interaction or...
No, keep it at production, production all the database.
Without breaking everyone's.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I don't think anything up here has interaction.
That's why I didn't think so. That's why I was.
Any more questions? Thank you.
I'm not quite sure how that translates.
Maybe it doesn't.
a volatile function or something, you wouldn't expect the volatile function to be, you know, executed more times than the limit.
Well,
yeah, I mean, it's not perfect, but I just mean that, I mean, it's kind of an